Rev heads are descending on Melbourne as the Formula One Grand Prix takes place this weekend. And our resident rev head and gorgeous woman, Ange Bishop, is trackside with some special guests. Good morning, darling. How are you?
Having enough fun for 10 people in the Channel 10 suite. Thank you very much, because I'm in my happy place. The only place I'm happier than a red carpet is next to Pit Lane, and then next to Pit Lane with two of my favourite stars of Neighbours. How are you, Takaya and Seven? It's so good to see you both.
I'm great. Great to be here.
Yeah, same. Ditto.
Are you rev heads like me? Do you like the smell of petrol in the morning?
I'm not sure if I like the smell of petrol, but I do enjoy a good race. I'm super competitive.
How about you? Are you knowledgeable about these sort of things?
I thought you were going to ask me if I like the smell of petrol, because I'm an arsonist, you know.
There's that.
You're not supposed to tell people that. I told you.
No, I'm not going to say I live for the Formula One, but yeah, I do. I love it. Yeah.
Yeah, look, it's so exciting. We haven't had a race here for 3 years. You can just feel the buzz that everyone's so excited to be back.
Mm. Oh, and it's phenomenal. I mean, as we were coming in, just seeing the difference in the crowd capacity was enough. You know, as you said, people are coming out of the woodwork because they haven't been able to do it for so many years. Yeah.
Do you know what's interesting? This year they're saying 38% of those who bought tickets are women. Women are really flocking to the track in big numbers. It was only about 24% 3 years ago. I think you were giving me the theory that the drive to survive Doco's got people interested.
Yeah, I think the emotional connection, the story that gets told through that series, it makes people connected to the drivers. Yeah. So I feel like that could drive a female response, definitely.
Yeah, just amazing. Now, the track's a bit different this year. I know Steph, you and I were going through some of the facts and figures before. Only 14 corners instead of 16. It's going to make a difference.
I know there's going to be a lot of spin-outs because some of the drivers are going to be driving and go, whoa, hang on a second, what happened at corner 15? there's 14 now instead of 16, so shorter track. And also the cars have completely changed as well. To me, it appears that they're not as open as what they used to be. It's more closed-in shell with much greater aerodynamics, even around the wheels and everything now. Yeah.
What they're saying is it's going to mean the changes to track are going to mean it's more passing, which is what we love to watch as spectators. And Daniel Ricciardo, Australia's Formula One driver in the McLaren, loves passing.
He does. He does.
And shoeies.
And so what?
And shoeies.
And well, he's got his own boot decanter now, so I wonder if he'll pull it out today or on the weekend at least.
Well, hopefully he's on the podium and has to do the real thing. Now, I can't have you guys here without talking about how it's going with the sad news that Neighbours is going to wind up. But it sort of also means you must have some amazing storylines you're working on at the moment, which you won't be able to tell me about. But is it quite exciting times?
Absolutely. I mean, it's a very sad time, but it's kind of an exciting time to be a part of, because I think people are going to tune in and watch towards the end, and there's some amazing stuff planned, so it's super exciting.
Basically what we're doing, and I know this sounds really strange, but we're condensing what we were going to do over the rest of the year, and a bit more obviously, into the next couple of months.
That's going to be action-packed.
You betcha. And I mean, you hit it on the nail. Because the thing about it is the producers don't want it to go out with a whimper. Obviously, they want it to go out with a bang, but not a tragic bang, a really nice and community-feel bang, which is what Neighbours is about, really.
But we're going to be rollercoastering our way till then.
Yeah, yeah. You think it's a race today.
That is incredible. Well, we're going to be catching up with you guys a lot more as we get towards that pointy end of proceedings. But as you say, it's still amazing. You've had one of the most important storylines ever in an Australian drama, the first same-sex marriage. It still must, you know, pinch yourself that you were part of such a storyline like that.
Yeah. I mean, as an actor, you can only do the roles that you're given, and to be given the opportunity to represent a community in that way, to have the first same-sex marriage on Australian television from when it was legalised, was a huge honour for both Matt and I, and it's something that can never be taken away, and that I will hold that precious for the rest of my life.
Yeah, and all of the dastardly deeds you've got up to that you could never do in real life.
I don't know what you're talking about. Paul's a lovely bloke. I'm going to miss all of that. Miss that fun, because Paul can be deliciously evil at times. That'll be sad, but it's good, as you say. You know, it's we're looking forward to what we're going to present now, rather than be sad and pessimistic about the ending. Yeah.
That's the way to do it. Well, it is so exciting to have you guys here with me in the 10th suite when the races are going to start. Now, you at home, if you want to watch the Formula One practice sessions, straight after Studio 10, switch over to 10 Bold, and there'll be two practice sessions this afternoon when all those drivers get out in the cars. It'll be so exciting.
Yeah, I can't wait.
I'm looking forward to the Porsche race next.
I might have been a Porsche action myself.
Oh, yeah. No. He's just wanting a deal with Porsche now.
Anyone interested, you know where to contact you. Hey, we will check back in with you a bit later as we get more action here from the Formula One Grand Prix in Melbourne.
Can't wait for it, Ange. Thanks, Jens. Appreciate it.